我还以为这个只是戏里面看到的，但是其实在河谷镜里面有这么多这样子的家庭。
I cannot accept it that this kind of situation actually happened in a city area.
Hunger is not a good feeling. So I want to help the people surrounding me. I'm not a good student. Actually, I failed my Form 5. Only when you fail Form 5, you come to society, you notice that study is important.The first job I do is a telecom subcom. 1 month, I get my salary 300. And my own pocket money is 50 ringgit. Average 1 day, I got 2 ringgit to eat. At that time, a bowl of chicken rice, 3 ringgit, I don't dare to eat on Monday. If I eat on Monday, means Tuesday, I only left 1 ringgit. I experienced that kind of feeling for 3 years.Not 3 months, not 3 days, but 3 years. After that, I found, hunger is not a good feeling. So I have a heart to say, if one day I'm more capable, I have better income, I want to help the people surrounding me. After a few years, my salary increased, I have better job. I earn 1,002 ringgit per month. Just a t-shirt salesman only. How to start? So I offer myself in the market to become a volunteer.
Okay.
In the year 2011, there was a big flood happened in Kuching. So government normally set up the flood center. So I am one of the volunteer only. After 3 days, the flood was gone. So the government will dispatch the people to go home. One elderly walked to me very slow, age of around 70 plus uncle. I call him Uncle Fu.He said, hey, young man, can you give me some food to bring home? I said, no problem, uncle. And in my heart, I also worried, will this uncle cheat me or not? If I don't go to his house, he got alpha at home. What to do, you know? So I said, uncle, why not I send you home? When I reached his home, he stayed at the Kampong Kude. His house is a wooden house without water and electric supply. Not only that, he not even have a gas stove. So I said, wow, this family really need help.Every week when I bring food to these locations, to this uncle, people pass by, you asking me, hey, where are you from? Why you are here? Or I say, I just want to buy some food to bless this uncle. And people starting to ask help from me, hey, how about, can you help me? I also need help. After 3 months, it grew out to 15 family. Oh, that is really a challenge coming.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Ada kasut bagi kamu orang sah.
With my own income, I finish it also cannot, not enough to support. So I feel very burdened, very, very, very sad, you know. How can I help all? But my resources is not enough. So I starting to share. Everywhere, no matter who I meet, as long as got time to meet people, I will share with people, hey, I need food. That is how the thing spread, more and more people give me food.I have 2 years cannot celebrate Chinese New Year because all the donation food item was in my sitting room. So my daughter, Grace, always complained, Daddy, when can you move away the noodle? I said, why? I can't watch TV for almost 1 year plus, you know, because all your stock was blocking the TV. By end of 2012, I take care of 48 family. So my pastor suggested me, we need to accountability.For the good people donate. Because I do it alone, I don't have any paperwork, I don't have any record, nothing. Just everything here. You know? So that I starting to take the advice, and I go to register the NGO, so Hot Place was born. I still doing the same thing in my mind, but only with a name of NGO.Until a certain I receive call from public who asking for help and I not enough time to go and delay for 2 to 3 weeks. So the person who call is quite angry and say, hey man, I already tell you already, almost 3 weeks, you haven't come to interview me. How long should I wait? okay, I saw one man cannot do so much already. It's time to hire people. So I voice out to my presidents and my main committee, and then we all agree to hire a staff.
Matang, so just packing this one, for this one to packing, means that we have to inform that.
How do you feel about Kevin?
Kevin? Interesting guy.
Why you say he's a very interesting guy?
Kevin is a person that tested my patient a lot. When I have thing in mind, I want to do it, means that I have to get it done. 1, 2, 3, 4. But with Kelvin, it doesn't happen like that. For him, no need to think. Kesian, tak ada duit, tolong.
Heidi is a very, very careful and detailed person. Every decision she makes, she will think twice, she will think longer. Actually, she covered all my weaknesses.
How is it like work together with Heidi? Do you have a head?
I don't have a head that, but different people background, different idea. So of course we got crash, we got quarrel, you know, because different background. My one is chung ah, go, you know. I don't know behind all die already. I still go. But she's the one to my black. Hey, slow down.
There's a lot of poor people outside there. We cannot help everybody. So I have to consider, I have to weigh it whether okay or not, yes or no. So there's a lot of thinking in my part. We don't stress ourselves. We work, we take in as we are able to. But of course, you must be sincere to it lah. So Kelvin, he's yes man. I am the no man. So that's a check and balance. Okay, most of my staff, they are young. I consider them young, except myself and Kelvin. They have the heart. They really have the heart. Without them, Hope Place cannot grow, honestly speaking, because with myself alone, I cannot do so many things. So with them, we can do a lot of things. MCO time. They're actually very restless. My staff keep on asking me, when can we go out? I'm thinking whether this auntie still got food or not. I keep on telling them there's nothing we can do. We just have to stay home because it's a direction from the government. Actually, I'm also struggling because I know that the poor people, my client, all these poor auntie uncles and these families, they actually need a lot of this food aid already. But because of restriction, we cannot go. When CMCO come, then the government announced that, okay, we can apply for permit, traveling permit. They actually say yes. They go through the hassle, go and queue up in the police station under the sun very long until they get the permit. They are so happy. Okay, let's go. I mean the vibrant is there. They start to mobilize themselves. I was so amazed. Okay, you do packing, you do this one, you do this one, you do this one. By the time I come to the office, I see that all of them working already. Yeah, so I appreciate them during this COVID virus season. They actually go all out. I mean, they go to all these red zone, the high risk place, to make themselves available and useful during this season. I really amazed of their heart and their passion towards their work that's given to them.
Nanti ini dia tak ada kerja, dia sebagai suri rumah saja, bantu-bantu saya. Saya saja yang turun ke laut. Waktu tengkujuh macam ni, saya tak turun ke laut lah. Kami kerja tangkap ikan, tangkap udang di laut. Tak menentu pendapatannya kan. Kadang ada, kadang tak ada. Tak menentu lah. Lagipun kita turun dalam masa sebulan, paling-paling dapat 10 hari ataupun 12 hari saja ke laut. Lepas tu tak dapat, air dah tak kuat, kita tak ke laut lah. Macam tu.
Dia tidak cun jam dia balik ada risau sikit lah.
Sebab waktu tu mungkin cuaca laut ada ribut kan, ada ribut, ada ombak. Kadang saya lambat sampai sini, lambat sampai ke rumah lah. Sebab kuasa enjin saya kuasa 15 kuda tak cukup kuat untuk melawan angin yang kuat kan. Jadi lambat sikit dengan ombak besar, saya tak dapat laju je lah. Lambat sikit sampai ke sini lah. Pernah sejarah satu kali, air sampai ke siling ini. Sampai itu, sejak itu kalau saya tak berani nak sambung masuk kawat elektrik.
Hope is very important for humans. When we're giving hope to that person, he'll be changed. He'll get encouragement, he'll get become positive. So I want to do my best to bring hope to the blessed wherever I am. A retired soldier come to me, say, Kelvin, we got abandoned couple need help in my village. So after I come back, I spoke to my team, and we immediately packed the food. Next morning, we run back to the house. Actually, we get a very basic item, very basic food supply to this uncle and auntie. It may be cost only 1 month, only less than 200 ringgit for all the items. So before I left, normally my attitude is I go to shake hand with the uncle. I say, okay, uncle, auntie, I come to see you next month. Suddenly, the nene hand hold my hand very tight, you know, and pull out and kiss my hand with the teardrop on my hand, you know, a very warm teardrop on my hand. And the nene said, terima kasih. Well, at that time, my heart was so, so warm. I said, nene, this encouragement can last me for another 20 to 30 years for my charity works.
以前还没有在希望之家做工之前呢，慈善机构的时候，我就觉得应该是没有人会帮助啦，或者只有那几个人，或者有公司这样子帮忙而已。但是没有，其实他们看到报纸啊，或者是知道，他们都会给予他们能够给的，他们都会不是说只有大老板或者很有钱的人，学生什么有力的出力，有钱的出钱。 多多少少都有一点一些不一样的人来帮忙捐助，所以真的是人间有爱。
Kalau dah terima barang macam ni pun kami orang dah berterima kasih banyak. Cukup dah, lebih daripada cukup dah. Sebab selagi pun saya boleh bekerja, saya boleh dapat carilah. Cari kerja sikit-sikit macam ni. Dapat bantu untuk kami dua. Hiduplah, terus hiduplah. Macam tu lah.
人家常常问我，为什么你常常笑？我就想，没有什么很多的烦恼，就是说，因为我也看过很多这些这么贫穷、这么可怜的家庭，那我们又算什么呢？其实我们常常以为自己很多东西都没有，常常埋怨自己没有这个没有那一个，但是其实我们都有，当我们去看这些家庭的时候，就觉得，哎。 为什么我还在一直埋怨我自己的生活？
For my generation, NGO is the last thing that you will do. Yeah. For my parents, you only do get involved in NGO when you are rich. You know, old people, they have their own thinking, right? So we have to bear with it lah. So there's a struggle.
其实我父母亲一开始的时候，其实他们也是蛮反对的啦，因为我身为一个女孩子，可能他们就讲，哎，你这么要去做这些，干这些活，然后去这么肮脏的地方啊，这样子，我也明白父母的心，就是要给女儿最好的嘛，呀，所以这样子，所以父母亲也会讲，去找一份比较好的工作。 一开始大家都想要找一份很好的工作，在上班，然后这样子很好的薪水，然后我就想，我在一个 NGO 做过，那时候就只有半天哦，这样子的工作跟人家分享应该是很丢脸啊，我不知道我朋友会不会笑我，我也不会出去跟朋友 hang out， 就可能给很多理由说我没有空啦，这样子呀，是因为怕他们问到我你现在在做什么的时候，我不知道怎样回答他们。其实是 Uncle Kelvin， 我们的 founder， 然后他就问我，哎呀，你要来跟我一起来帮忙去帮助贫穷啊？我讲，哎，可以啊，我很喜欢，因为去帮助人嘛。 我那时候的感受是觉得，怎样能够在这样子的地方生存？就这么肮脏，你不会有疾病啊、生病吗？还是什么？我还以为这个只是戏里面看到的，但是其实在一个小小的古镇里面，其实有这么多这样子的家庭。
所以这样子也因你看他们就很特别开心，开心你看会开心吗？哎呦，我做两个晚上故意睡哦，我要等你们，没有人在我去希望之家，没有人在。2015年3月23号我打，2015年3月25号星期三他们就送来了嘛，车楼里不是有后配的。 那个字我就手举高高啊，举高高，他们就stop咯，在我进来咯，真的真的，我还记得阿眼彼得，Kevin还有一个女孩子戴眼镜的，那个是谁？是他们送来了，送来我就看，哇，这样多东西呀，哎，我很高兴，看这样多东西，哇，好，我多么高兴，就像他们把我当家人看待，比家人还要像家人嘛。 你讲对吗？ Satu pun saya sendiri punya dua orang anggap saya mama, betul ke? Saya tengok dua orang satu pun saya punya anak.
你有没有话想对阿颖啊、弟弟哥啊、对可心啊、对 Kevin 啊、对希望之家有没有什么话想要跟他们讲？我就是很感谢他们哦，他们就是很感谢希望之家。
5、6年了，6年帮我，减轻我的家庭负担，他们把我当成是家人，比家人还要像家人，所以我很感谢他们，因为，我家人对我一点都没有，一块钱都不曾给我买，一罐牛奶都不曾给我，真的，我不是讲骗的，所以我。 不知道要怎样感谢，用写最好，对吗？
Aunty itu ya memang aunty itu kuat bagus lah ya. Dia memang pandai berdiri di kari lah. Kemas lah, kamu tengok dia punya rumah semua kemas, dia tersusun. Setiap kali dia sebut Kevin, dan Ayen saya, dan Heidi lah. Sebab dia rasa bersyukur lah dia cakap lah. Dia bersyukur sebab Hopeless memang betul-betul bantu dia lah ya.
让我最坚持做下去应该是很多的体会到当我们去帮助别人然后当帮助到他们的时候他们那个很开心的笑容在他们的脸上最印象深刻的其实是一个单亲母亲她就生了一个OKU的孩子 我就有一天不知道就想起了他，我就打电话给他，然后讲：“哎，经理好吗？”他就哭，然后他就讲：“哦，其实前两天我想要打电话给你们，是因为我的孩子去世了。其实很感恩你们这一直以来的帮助，在这几年里面给我们一个很大的帮助啦，支撑。然后他就让我看到，哎，其实我们一些小小的动作可以给他们带来这么大的改变。” 所以他记得，然后他就感恩，讲谢谢，他是给我一个很大的一个动力，去继续在这个希望之家里做一次，因为我想要看到更多的家庭有改变吧。嗯。Actually,
I'm very blessed. Have a great team, Heidi, Ayen, Griffin. Peter, Kersing, Lisa, and Magdalene, Felicia, Susie, all the team. I want to thank every one of them because me alone, I cannot do so much. But together as a team, everyone help one another, we can help more people. And I also want to take this opportunity to thank all the donors, no matter big or small, it doesn't matter. Because for me, it's a heart. Helping people doesn't affect you're qualified or not qualified. You are rich or you are poor. It doesn't matter. The only thing for me is, are you willing or not? Are you willing or not?
Why Hopeless? Why the name Hopeless?
Because I want to bring hope to that place wherever we are. Not just physically give food, but we want to touch that person's life. So I name it Hopeless.